Ms. Watkins, how about yourself? Is there anything that you want to say today?
No, just that I'm sorry that this situation even happened. That's pretty much it. Me losing my baby is already a life sentence by itself, so.
You know, it's interesting, Ms. Watkins. I remember the coverage that this situation received by the news. We have some tissue there. And I remember reading it and looking at it, and it was amazing to me how they demonized you and called you the world's worst person in the world. They even executed a search warrant in your house and found beer and decided that you must be a substance abuser. I don't know how many times when people have seen a fire that they go and breathalyze and test people who have suffered a tragedy to try to help support their case and call you an unfit mother.
Yeah, they breathalyzed me.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And guess what? Not an ounce of alcohol was found in because it had nothing to do with it. Friends talked about what their parents had done and what they have done in terms of, you know, when people decide to leave their children. And people can pretend like they've never done anything like that. But everybody that I can think of has left their children at some point or not followed their children carefully. There are people, I coach baseball, there are people that will leave the playground thinking they have their children only to turn back around and realize they've left their child at the playground. And but for an act of God, that child didn't run out in the street and get hit by a car, because then the parent would have said, well, you left and didn't even know where your kids were. It's so quickly to find blame in somebody else's life and their situation and excuse all the missteps that people have taken. This report shows that you are a responsible person, an employed person, a person that demonstrates care and concern, that you're so much different than how you were portrayed and demonized. And to me, it's just unfortunate and sad. Would life have been different if the cell phone had been in your house?
I would have never left.
Absolutely. And so sometimes it's a matter of economics. I mean, you know, I'll give you a quick story. My uncle was in the Army and was at Fort Bragg in Kentucky. And he was supposed to be, quote unquote, watching us. This was back in the 50s, and so the next thing he knew, somebody was knocking on his door, waking him up, saying, is this your kid outside? I had left the house where he had been watching me and was riding a tricycle naked up and down the neighborhood. A lieutenant in the Army nodded out when the kids took a nap. And there I am, naked as a jaybird, rolling on that tricycle. I'm happy that nothing happened, but nowadays he would have been neglectful. Well, the agreement was for 1 to 15 years in the state prison and dismiss count two, and so I will, as the agreement has asked, enforce the agreement. But if you qualify for the alternative sentencing boot camp, then you'll receive my no objections to entering into the boot camp. So that's the sentence of the court. You don't have an absolute right to appeal the sentence. If you want to appeal, you have 21 days from today's date to fill out the form. given to you. Good luck.
Thank you.